myalgic encephalomyelitis, commonly called chronic fatigue syndrome. It's a life-altering, debilitating disease affecting the brain, the immune system, and energy metabolism. Symptoms can appear suddenly or have a gradual onset and include a profound lack of energy that is not relieved by rest. Other symptoms can include unrefreshing sleep, cognitive impairment, dizziness, severe headaches, pain, sore throat, sound and light sensitivity, and many more symptoms. There are no FDA-approved treatments. There is no cure.
I think the cardinal parts of the illness are what's called post-exertional malaise, where any kind of effort, physical but also mental, makes all of the symptoms worse, typically about 12 to 48 hours afterwards.
When you look at the patient perspective, post-exertion malaise is described as a debilitating crash following minimal exertion that can take weeks to recover from.
And for some people, even getting out of bed to do anything will cause post-exertional malaise, while other people can be in the house and do okay. But if they try to go out even to a doctor's appointment, they induce post-exertional malaise.
And this is a worsening of illness under almost any type of stressor. Physical, cognitive, emotional stressors can all trigger relapse with this illness. The duration of the effect can be days, weeks, months, and sometimes forever. So sometimes people do not recover.
This person wrote in, when I do any activity that goes beyond what I can do, I literally collapse. My body is in major pain. It hurts to lay in bed. I can't hardly talk. I can't find the words. It hurts to think. I feel my insides are at war. There are days that I just want to cry because I can't take care of myself. I need help.
Well, it varies from patient to patient, but in the most severely affected cases, and I've seen an awful lot of these, patients lie in a darkened room because they can't tolerate light or noise. They're in chronic pain. Most of them are unable to move and unable to speak. And at the moment, there is literally nothing that can be done to help those that are really severely affected.
And that's the shocking thing about ME. These families are left to cope all on their own.
Here's a person that has laid in that bed for 6 years. He cannot talk, he cannot eat, he cannot look at us. We have a tube into the top of his intestine for feeding. He cannot drink, so we have another line into his chest that goes into his heart for giving him saline. So I would challenge any of the government officials to say that this is not real. There's nothing wrong. To look at the data and look at the patients. This is not the only patient like this. There's thousands and thousands of people like this. It's like one of the worst diseases you could have. And it's also the least funded.
Many doctors still don't know that over the last 35 years, there have been over 9,000 scientific publications that compare people with the illness to healthy people and that find a whole variety of abnormalities, like energy metabolism. That is, the ability of the cells to make energy and to use energy seems to be compromised in a wide variety of ways.
I I looked on the NICE website and I read that this was an illness that would get better with cognitive behavioral therapy and graded exercise. And I thought, well, that's not what I've got, because I'm mentally extremely strong and exercise makes me worse. So I completely disregarded that diagnosis for myself for a good 3 months.
One of the first things this physician should do is stop telling the patient to go exercise. This is one disease you cannot exercise.
The first graded exercise program I tried was early on in my illness, and it made me much worse. Most people I know with ME have exactly the same experience with it.
And then I was given graded exercise therapy, and after that I was completely bedridden for 2 years. I was really, really, really sick. So graded exercise therapy can actually be harmful.
First law should be to do no harm, to not make the condition worse by allowing the patient or pressurizing the patient to do too much.
So what we would advise patients with this illness to do is to pace their activities so that they are not exceeding their limitations. They are dividing their physical and their mental activities into little small chunks. What is important not to do is to push on to the point of physical exhaustion and fatigue, because then you are just going to get a prolonged period when you're not going to be able to do anything because of this symptom of post-exertional malaise.